Ferments and fermentation technology have always been around in both the dairy industry, as in cheese and yogurt, and the meat industry, fermented meats and sausages. Oddly, fermentation technology was not used for vegetables. My name is Tony Savard. I'm a researcher at Agriculture Canada and a trained microbiologist. The large food companies that produce fermented vegetables tend to pasteurize them. This results in a loss of quality and loss of taste, but it also gives long-term stability. The small companies that have come to us for help sell live, unpasteurized foods. What we did was to take a little of what existed in other foodstuffs to select the best ferments. Using those, we were able to develop ferments that allow the product to be stored at room temperature for several months. Without preservatives, without pasteurization, without refrigeration, and without any of the new technologies that we have today. Often with fermentation, the whole of the vegetable does not get fermented. There's secondary fermentation. There are microorganisms called yeasts that produce gas, such that they can cause glass jars to explode. In a distribution network or food market, that is not feasible. Therefore, even if the product is excellent with excellent quality, the shelf life would be affected by secondary fermentation. So what we did is that we researched the microorganisms responsible for fermentation. We selected them, which gave not only better processing results, but also better results in terms of quality, taste, and bioactivity. And then we reintroduced those bacteria as ferments. Obviously, the fermented vegetable market is for everyone, but primarily vegetarians and vegans. Ferments are small bacteria that have been made into a powder or in a powdered milk-based medium. We saw that there was a demand for something entirely plant-based. Therefore, the latest technologies that we have developed to meet that demand are fully vegan ferments, meaning ferments derived from plants, then freeze-dried on plant-based matter, and then used to process vegetables. Food today crosses borders, and we must ensure that food continues to maintain its viability. Fermentation increases food safety. Why? Because with fermentation, not only are the beneficial properties of the food maintained, but it also creates a host of composites with antimicrobial properties. They get rid of bad bacteria, not the good bacteria. Therefore, we get food that can be kept for a long time, cannot be contaminated, and that detoxifies other foods when mixed with, because it contains natural antimicrobial agents. It becomes a superfood in the category of foods and scientific innovations. There was an obvious need in the industry, and they came knocking on our door. Here at Agriculture Canada, we have various programs to support the industry. One of those programs was a capital cost-sharing program. It helps to minimize risk and to do work that actually meets industry needs. To take an old technology that is practically prehistoric, to modernize it and to enhance the beneficial effects of this processing and preservation technique is an interesting validation. It is interesting from the consumer, industrial, and from a research perspective as well.